Well, hey guys, welcome back to another video at Morehead Homestead. Before we begin, if you guys would, make sure you like, subscribe, and ring that notification bell. Alrighty, what we got today, I don't know if I have enough light to do all these or not. I've been running and gunning since I got off, but I found these guys on the way home from hunter's practice the other day. And what I'm wanting to do with these, because them cows and goats just, when you walk in their feed buckets, they just run you over. Lindy can't go in there anymore to feed any of that. So what I'm going to do, I plan on taking two of these. I got three of them. I'm going to take two of these. I'm going to cut them in half long ways. And then I'm going to drill a few holes and use some baling wire and anchor them to the bottom of a T-post out there just so they can't drag it off. And I'll be able to feed from over the fence. We'll have to go in there to feed. So anytime we do need to go in there, we can just put some feed out. They'll be over there eating. Then we can go to the chicken pen or whatever we need to do. So that is the plan on these. Like I said, man, the sun is fading fast. But I'm going to try to get one of these done at least. They had soap in it from the car wash. So I'm going to have to, once I cut this in half, clean it out real good. Which it should make it super easy once it gets cut in half to clean all the soap out, so that won't be an issue. Like to thank all of you guys once again for clicking on this video, and let's get started. Alrighty, well, there's one of them finished product. That's probably all I'm gonna get done today. I'm gonna get it washed out and try to get it put over in the pen today. Probably won't get it anchored down, but I at least wanna get them in there. So I'm gonna drag the hose out here now, start washing. You can see the soap in here. So I gotta get all the soap out and all the plastic pieces out of there. Most of it's on me. I don't know if you can see it. But most of it's on me. All right, I'm gonna get this hose stretched out and then we'll get her washed up.
This is some stout stuff, though.
Better go unplug that extension cord. Alrighty, well, not only did I get the totes cut in half and all washed up, but I got a good wash job done on most of the basketball court here. So it really needed that. Man, I feel like these things maybe need to dry out. Let me check. Alright guys, we're back as promised. I don't know if you guys can see that bright purple tree behind me, that red bud, but it was planted when I was born, so that is my tree. Zoom in a little bit, let you see it. It's blooming nice and pretty. But what I'm gonna do today, you've seen the first part of this video, we cut these in half. So today, I'm going to drill a few holes in the bottom so the water will drain out, and then drill a couple on the side to run that baling wire through, and then we will tie it up to the T-post and throw some feed in there and see how it works. What you talking about? Want to be better. All right, let's go to get back.
She's trying to lick you.
Get back.
No. Should have fed them.
Get back.
They're going to be all up in your business.
I know. Don't you lick me. Quit. Quit. Go. Hey, run down there and shake that bucket like it's got feed in it, Hallie.
All right, take it over there.
No, just walk down there. See? There you go.
April Fools.
Yeah, April Fools. One more.
How many of these are you doing?
Just these two right now.
I think you're gonna need a couple more. Just to spread them out, you know?
Alright.
Test them out?
Test them out.
What?
Gonna test out these new feed bins.
Am I done?
Yes, you're done.
I was laying there just like I was pushing the cord. So they'll come closer and
It may take a while before they
figure it out.
Realize that there's two of them. Lucy over here figured out
a lot better though. They got a lot more space. Lucy's like, yes, I get one to myself. You gotta turn the water hose on. Hey, you are. Get in there, bud. Get in there. Look, you got your little pig. Oh, Lucy's like, oh, are you feeding me over there?
Alrighty, well, it looks like this will be the way to go if I'm not home or anything like that, so Lindy can feed. There. Got the water filling up. Got Eeyore here grubbing down. So it definitely was a success. This will make feeding a lot easier on the homestead. I'll probably do that to one more tote or barrel, split it up and put it somewhere, probably along here on these ones. T-posts and just go through here and have two for the goats and two for the cows and go that route. But we got the big Easter program tonight for the school, so we'll be getting ready pretty soon and headed up there. You had a doctor's visit today?
Yeah.
Okay, updates?
Coming up on 3 pounds. He's got quite a bit of hair.
Did you say it or he's?
It.
Okay.
And I told her my back's been really hurting, and she said, well, it's because the baby's super low and it's up against your spine. So I said, well, that makes sense. My back's hurting, so it's low.
Heart rate was
136.
Oh, what's that mean?
I am craving ice, like Sonic ice, which I know is like an iron deficiency, they say, but that's what I craved with Hunter, like really bad. So now I'm like, I think I'm switching. I'm like,
but
now,
you didn't with her, right?
No. So now I'm like, crud, I really think it's a boy now because it's so low and I'm craving what I craved with Hunter. So anyway, it's measuring big. So maybe we'll have it early. So we'll see.
Hunter, what do you think about having a new little brother?
We are?
We don't know.
We don't know. Is that what you want, though? Is that what we are? What do you think?
I don't know.
You don't care, do you?
No. I just want a brother or sister.
You just want something?
Just a baby to hold.
Here's a little bit closer look at this tree. It's really bloomed out. I don't remember
it. It's so purple.
I don't remember it being this purple yesterday. But it is really bloomed up. It's a kid's favorite tree to climb.
My florizanth just skipped from being yellow straight to green. It's got a few yellow flowers.
Usually
it just gets bright yellow.
Normally it's super yellow.
But it just skipped the yellow and went green.
There's a few of them on there. But not very many.
Last year it got really yellow. What you think this year it would have with all this rain and warm temperatures?
We have feet, Sissy. My feet are coming in.
Alrighty, well, you can see we're all ready for the Easter program. What happened on Good Friday? Hunter, what did...
He died on the cross.
Yes, died on the cross. On the Friday before Easter, right? That's today, isn't it?
You want to tell them your poem?
Our Father's love, God, our Father's love is deep and true. He cares about people like me and you. He sent Jesus to show us the way so we may live in heaven with him someday.
Good job.
Sissy. Good job, Sissy.
Yours.
You got a
poem? It's long.
Do it.
Yeah. Look right here and do it.
Betrayed. Ally of the Roman soldiers, Judas betrayed Jesus with a kiss. Once this was done, the Son of God walked away without raising a fist. Denied by his disciples and placed on trial by men. The outlook for Jesus was not easy to comprehend. Beaten and taunted, back and forth he went. To and from the courts of Caesar for his sentence. Finally, it was decided by a crowd that the priest had persuaded that the judgment to be would be crucify him. Towards Golgotha hill with the cross on his back. Jesus walked in pain while still being attacked. The cross was so heavy, his condition was very bad. So Simon of Cyrene carried the cross. Nailed to the cross were Jesus' hands and feet. It wouldn't be long now before he was in his proper seat. Pierced in his side, the water and blood did flow. After he cried, Father, into your hands I commit my spirit, his life did go. Buried in a borrowed tomb, he was raised from the dead. In 3 days, exactly just like he said, power from his shed blood has been achieved. Victory over the enemy now abides, for Jesus spoke. If I be lifted up, I'll draw all men to me. There.
Good job, Sissy. That was long. Alrighty, so from everyone at the Moorhead Homestead, we'd like to wish you guys a great Good Friday. Remember the reason for this weekend. It's not Easter bunnies and eggs. It's that Jesus on today, 2,000 years ago, went to the cross and bore sins for many people, and that anyone who would call upon the name of Christ will be saved. So if any of you guys watching this video or listening to this have not called out to Christ for salvation, we would encourage you to do so. And this Sunday is Resurrection Sunday, the day where the tomb was emptied. He defeated death, overcame it. And so hope all you guys will attend some church this Sunday. You got to hear the Easter message for yourself. And we'd like to thank all you guys for watching this video once again. You got anything, Hunter?
No, not really.
How'd the kids do on their poems? I did not know Hallie's was so long. That was super long. You did good. You gotta do it good and loud here in a little bit also.
I know.
Alrighty, thanks everybody for watching this video and more from Moorhead Homestead. Hey, if you guys like this video, make sure you smash that like button. If you haven't subscribed to our channel yet,
make sure you like and subscribe.
And
ring the notification bell.
And that's it.
Oh, I was like, I don't know.
Alright guys, thanks for watching. And until next time, God bless.